Hello everyone, welcome to our today's session about how to get Google certified and what are the advantages of becoming a Google certified professional. Now, the first advantage of being a certified professional is it showcases your skill set to a potential employer. If you are applying for a job and you have these certifications on your resume, it looks very professional and it will be a kind of positive thing for on your resume, so that the employer can know that you are actually a certified professional who has the knowledge of the subject. Number two, if you are looking for freelancing projects, now most of the platforms like Upwork or even Fiverr or freelancer.com, all of these platforms has an option of certifications tab, where by displaying your certification, it increases the confidence in your ability from your client point of view, and that will also help you to generate this benefit from this certification. And number three, if you are working for an agency, most of the agencies have something called as Google Partner Program. In next video, I'm going to explain you about what is Google Partner Program. Now, if you work for any agency, in that agency, if there are more certified professional, that will be a positive for the entire agency in terms of their partner status. So these are three basic advantages. One for a job point of view, number two for the point of view of our freelancing projects, and number three, if you're working for an agency, being certified in that agency can add value to your overall agency. Now the question is, how do we get certified? So very simple answer for this is Google provides a completely free of cost option to write the certifications. In the beginning, Google have charged $50. I'm talking about like 10-15 years back, they used to charge $50 per exam. Now everything is free of cost, and Google have given a portal called as Google Skillshop. So you can just go to the Google search engine and type the keyword Google Skillshop. Now once you go to the Google Skillshop, basically you get the first URL here. So just click on this URL and you will be good to go to log in and then get into your actual account. So this is completely free of cost, and the only thing you have to consider is while writing the certification exam, make sure that whatever the name you want to get printed on your certificate, you have to have that account as your actual email, actual name of that email ID, so that whatever the name you have for your email will get printed on the certification. So now if you see here, we have pretty different number of programs to do. One is Google Ads, one is Google for Education, Google Marketing Platform, and so on. So as our goal is to learn how do we get certified, so I will go into the option of Google Ads. So click on that option, and here we have different level of certification. So basically Google provide six different certification levels. Let us understand each one of them individually. First one is called as a search. Now search specialization is basically to show your expertise in PPC campaigns and search campaigns. Second one is a display certification, which is to show your expertise in display advertising campaign. Measurement is more about optimization and reporting and analysis of the reports. And then we have Google Ads video, which is specifically for video campaigns. If you want to show your expertise in YouTube, then I would recommend you to complete the video certification. Then you have shopping ads certification to show expertise in shopping ads. And then you have Google Apps certification, which is basically for the purpose of showing your expertise in app promotion. And recently they have added one more new certification, which is about Google Ads creative certification, which is about creatives, basically working on different types of creatives. Google have introduced this new particular campaign as well. So these are the different campaigns you have, the different types of certifications you have. So what is recommended is minimum start with one certification. As I said in the video in the beginning, I'm going to take a small mock test and example for you, so that you can understand what type of questions basically come up in this examination. So I'll just go ahead on the top and Google Ads search certification. And if you ask, sir, what is the study material, where can I study about all of this subject as well, if you are new to this industry, then you can just scroll down to the bottom here, and here we have a complete list of complete table of content for working, studying the Google Ads search, where you will learn about different topics, and each of this topic, like 15 minutes, 32 minutes, different types. It's a combination of text as well as a video based programs are available across all of this option. So if you are new, I would recommend you please go through each of this option, then only attempt for a certification. If you already have completed Google Ads, you can right away go and write the exam. So let's take our first assessment here. So I'll just go for the Google Ads search assessment, click on that option. And one more important thing here is, even if you fail the exam, no problem at all, because you can able to rewrite the exam after 24 hours of the time. So just click on confirm, and now the exam is 75 minutes and total 50 questions will be there, and we have to score at least 80% marks in this exam. Now questions will be very, very basic, very easy questions will be asked in this exam. So I'm just going for a launch option, so we can see some of the simple questions, and you can also try to answer this question. So see the first question we have over here. Basically the question is, there is one HHA company is there, which are working on new smart refrigerator. They know that widget code, this is one of their competitors. They also actually offer the same thing. So, and they have a broad match keyword of refrigerator and also adds widget code as a negative. So question is, which two searches may prompt the ad? Meaning, which of this following will trigger the ad? Now we know about negative keyword. Whenever the word negative keyword is there, the ad will not show. So let's just remove what is where the ad won't show. So we can say number one here, widget code is available here. The ad won't show for this. Widget code is available here. Ad won't show for this. And widget code is available here. Ad will not show for this. So answer for this question is very simple. Energy efficient fridge, that is option one. And then the last option, smart refrigerator review. So because the word negative keyword whenever is found, automatically Google will not show the ad. So this is the right answer, option one and option and last option. Let's try the second one. Question is very simple. Pete is a marketing director for an electrical company. He recently chose leads as his Google search campaign marketing goal. So when you select a specific goal, maybe a leads, maybe different views of some goal. So here is the answer. Encourage customers to purchase the electric car. Yes, but basically people won't buy directly the electrical car. So increase email list signups from a potential customer. So I would say generally lead is considered as this, because direct purchase of electrical car is very, very rare. So I would say lead is basically, it's a sale. If you take sales, that is where you are selling something. But because we are looking for leads as our goal, increase email list signups for potential customers. So I will take the answer as 2. Now click on next. This is the third question. Now, this is actually, we have to match left side and right side, we have to match it together. This topic is related to audience targeting. If you see in the search campaign settings, we have an option of audience segments, where we have affinity audience, in-market audience and all. This is a question related to that. So I will just match it. So I will just click on next. It's exactly matching with the same option. So click on next. But sometime it will be random. So our answer is same. Next. Now, what is the main benefit of using search audience solution? Search audience is basically an option in search campaign when you select a specific set of audience. So what is that answer is? Please try for this answer yourself as well. All right. I hope you got the answer. Answer for this one is, they can help send the right message to the right customer with the right bid. Yep, because search audience, we can able to customize our audiences and we can customize the bids as well, and then automatically generate the keywords and identify an ad extension. No, they get detailed analytics insight. No, the answer is first, where we can go for a right message to the right customer at a right bid price by using audience segmentation. Next, campaign settings. What are the two options which are available to narrow down and target a specific audience? So here, as we know that what options we have in our targeting point of view in our search campaign, we already aware that location is one of the option by which we can target a specific audience, and also device type. We can able to exclude certain devices like desktops or tabs, etc. So these are the two options. Budget type and budget is not a factor, and web browser is also, we can't exclude in terms of search campaign. So answer is A and B. So two correct answers, so A and B. We can read the next question. All right. This is actually a question related to performance planner. Performance planner is a tool which is available under AdWords tool section. Under planning, you will find performance planner. Basically, two types of options are there. One is search planner and one is display planner. Basic idea of performance planner is it is actually going to help us understand and forecast the future. Like if we have 1 month of campaign data with us, next month, what will be the result? Next month, what will be the conversions we can get? So based on that, this question is, so which why should we separate the different objectives? To so that the spend is not reallocated between two different marketing objectives. I'll take the answer as C, but I'm not sure about this. All right, next. You can read the next question. Okay, question is, why should we choose automatic bidding instead of manual bidding? Now, this is a very straightforward question and answer for this question. Hope you can answer this question. You can try it once. All right. So I would say the answer is the first one. That is because given the dynamic nature of Google auctions, the appropriate bid can often be moving target. That's a challenging to reach at scale when using manual bidding. And that's the right answer. A. And let's go to the 8th question. Why is creating 3 or more search ads per ad group a best practice? Yeah, this is actually one of the best practice suggested by Google, to create 3 ads for each ad group. Now, reason for that answer we can try. So this is answer is last one. We have more ads based on what people are searching, what is the keyword people are searching. Based on that, we can actually show the right advertisement. So for that reason, Google can decide the best performing ad. Question number 9. All right, again, matching we have got. We have to match what is this call extension and what is the purpose of it. First one is a call out extension. So it highlights some value added option. Call is basically a phone, and structure snippet is about describing features, and site links is directing users to the website. So this is the right answer. Click next. And 10th question, we can upload an email. And also we can upload the mailing address, which is the location of the user, target location of the user. According to my opinion, this should be the right answer. And this is a concept. So I hope you understood the basic idea that this 10 questions like this, I have to answer further 40 questions. So here is what I just want to explain you overall about this concept. Now, if you have seen this mock exam, is just to show you how this overall exam is available, and also how simple and easy questions you get. You need to do a bit of 2 or 3 hours of study on this exam, and definitely you can able to pass this exam. I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have got a valuable information, please like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.